New Zealand's Northland, shrouded in tradition, mystery, and pioneering life.
I'm going to be riding the bike and presenting most of the time.
And I'm behind the cameras filming, bringing the Northland to you.
OneWheelDrive.net and Curbside are proud to take you with us on this adventure spanning Northland's rich history, sights, and people.
We left Waihau Omo Lodge early and are headed to the Wairarei Boulders. Geologists are awestruck at this world-class feature, and we've been told it's a geological fact that basalt doesn't flute. Well, according to Rita and Felix Shad, it does here.
With deep cuts, that's something geologists say doesn't happen, doesn't exist in the whole world. Actually, they say Mother Nature cannot do this to crystal hard rock because the rock is too hard. But here she obviously did, and it's a shock to every geologist in the whole world. And in their books it says basalt does not flute. They call it flutes, like organ pipes, deep cuts, you see, deep cuts. Like limestone has got flutes,
right.
But but some in there are even bigger than limestone. And limestone is just a sedimentary, like that.
Yeah,
I give you a hammer and a nail, try to bang a thing in there, you can't. It's amazing. And geologists freak out, that's why Felix and I, we put a bed there for them, because they get such a shock when they.
We just met the owners of the Wairarei Boulder Sanctuary. It's their farm. They've done all this up, and it's up to 2.5 hour walking track through boulders and palms and forest. And it looks like they've done a very impressive job, and they seem like really down to earth, decent people. It was just quite inspirational to us who are, you know, trying to change our ways a bit here and there, to hear someone wanted to get away from the stress and just do what they wanted to do. So it was good. I'm glad we went down the road and came here.
Wandering their property, it's pretty easy to see Rita is right. The basalt is fluted. I'm sure geologists would be beside themselves over the phenomenon, but we're just happy to enjoy this amazing walk and surrounds, even in the relentless northern heat.
They think it was the New Zealand kauri tree.
Okay.
So the acid, the tannin in the leaves, together with the rain, leached it out. Think, this is a good example. Think this one, this piece was standing up at some stage, and this was the top. It's like a bath here, right? The lava is never, when it comes, it's not quite flat, you know, it gets bumps in it. This is like a bath. And the rain in here and the leaves fell in here, and as well, when the rain came through the canopy of the big kauri trees, it took some of the acid with it, and then it stayed in there and then went vertically. Now this is horizontal here, but yeah, because it's fallen over. But you can imagine, can you? I can imagine really well with this here. And then it went sideways and floated it out over, it's roughly 3 million years, almost 3 million. Yeah, I know.
I tell you something,
you've got to be prepared for geologists thinking you are crazy, not the rocks.
Yeah,
or we,
of course.
Not you fellows, of course. But if you tell them, they'll think you are crazy. So don't worry, just tell them, or give them our website particulars and they can check it out. The geologists on our website. And it will be on the New Zealand map this year because they have to print a new map.
God. And I'm in my bike pants. I don't think we're doing the hour return to the lookout, unfortunately, but maybe next time.
We have the space. We should always take shorts and the bike with us on hot days like this where we plan to do excursions. So, overall, this was a $10 a head excursion and well worth it. It's just, it's well preserved. It's well laid out. You know, the grounds are kept nicely. It's just, it's cool. And if it's a hot day in Northland, this provides quite a bit of shade. Just don't wear your motorcycle gear if you tend to ride here, because that would just be foolish.
You or anybody wishes to know more, you can go on our website, and that's the geology which we printed out from
okay.
our website. And Felix made it, he made it real nice, this thing even moved, that's supposed to be the clay, and it even moves on the website so people can see how it's subsided, you know, with the rain. And without the clay it would not have happened either.
A lot of hard and personal work has been put into Why Ray Ray by Rita and Felix. It is worth doing the significant detour off the beaten track to witness it firsthand.
Leaving Rita and Felix, we continue north to Ahipara, where Destination Northland has organized a quad adventure for us from Tua Tua Tours.
One of my friends from here, they used to bring his mother out on a tractor, and they'd all come around, the ladies on the tractor out to here and pick all the seaweed. And then in the 60s there was a commune of guys that had stopped from the, hadn't gone to the Vietnam War. Americans,
yeah.
But yeah, they'd all...
The deserters?
Yeah,
whatever.
All the deserters, and they were all out around on the corner here, they had their own commune out here. So,
really?
Yeah, it wasn't much access back then, you'd hardly get any people around here, so they hung around there for about 10 years.
Quadding on the beaches of Ahipara, we make our way to the sand dunes, which is the local quadder's paradise. This is a great way to explore areas which would otherwise be completely inaccessible to cars, trucks, and motorcycles.
By the way, in case you're wondering, that dog's name is Diesel. And I bet that's because he goes for hours and hours.
One of the locals is showing off their stuff in his kitted out Raptor 750. Some of the shots really don't show how steep the bowl is.
Ahipara sits at the southern end of 90 Mile Beach, and in Maori it means sacred fire, in reference to a fire that was kept constantly burning by the local Te Rarawa people. Kauri gum was the major industry here back in the day. The gum would be carted to the beach and shipped down to Auckland. Those days are long gone, and Ahipara is now best known for holiday making, adventure, and wheeling the side of a 400-foot bull on a raptor.
He lives at the end of the bay there, so you just go and ride every day.
Go to the right, eh? Go to the right.
Yeah. Good.
Wow.
Any entertainment?
Yeah.
Gotta go and have the operation tomorrow, dude.
Oh, yeah. As far as my arm goes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just gonna go and get it straightened, you won't be able to ride.
Guess how I heard it. Been there, done that.
Yep.
Got the broken bones.
I pride myself in having a love of all vehicles, and I like to experience speed any way I can get it. But nothing I've ever been in, ridden, driven, or flown has prepared me for riding on the back of a Raptor 750 with a skilled, albeit slightly crazy, rider.
Back on the much more sedate Honda quads, we take in the view of Ahipara and the start of 90 Mile Beach. We say our goodbyes and hightail it to Hohora for the night. The quads and the boulders were an amazing experience, so different from each other, but still so very Northland.
$1 meal, which North American wise would be expensive. New Zealand is, you know, on the verge, but I guess the difference is the prices stay the same, the portions just keep getting larger the further away from Auckland you go.
So it's a healthy meal?
Hey, you can't blame me for this one. I ordered steak and salad.
Follow us on a 3-month motorcycle adventure around Australia. Joe rides the bike,
while Flora is our principal camera operator. It's the two of us as travelers and film crew. This is Australia, Inside Out.